Today is April 21st, Saturday. Boat launch is starting to get packed and backed up. So I'm in the water already. I started early just to avoid all this crowd here. Today we're going to be using this 10-foot pole. And it's I'll be using my spinning corky. And here's the outriggers I mounted on my boat. And we're going to be trolling about like 2 knots and drifting frozen anchovy. And this will keep it suspended from the bottom. And if you know the South Bay, there's a lot of junk on the bottom, so you don't want to trail a lot of stuff on your hook. We're going to be using frozen anchovy today. And these are about like 6 inches long. The body is about 5 inches. My hook sets are going to be from the bottom of the shank, which is this part right here, and this part measured at 4 inches. That way I can anchor it right into the head and bend the body just a little to get a nice spin to it. And we're going to be using the Shinsy fluorocarbon 40 pound key line. So you penetrate the bottom jaw to keep the mouth closed, and you slowly penetrate the head and make sure it's going through the right way, which is this one's good. So you just continue all the way until it's like that. Now you can see your trailer hook right there. It's lining up with the body. So if you hook this anchovy straight like that, it's not going to spin. So what I do is I find out where it's going to be at right here, so I can bend it. I can go down more. So what I'm going to do is fold this hook down, pointing the back. That way, give me some space to penetrate the body like that. See? And then I go like this. You don't want to go all the way through the body, just up to the spine. So then the tail is just bent just a little, just like that. And it'll give it a nice spin. It got hot out here. As you can see, we put up the canopy. This is an old canopy vinyl that I had to replace. So I went to Michael's sewing department, bought some Velcro and this vinyl, clear vinyl. And let me show you how I take it out. Here, hold this. So it's Velcroed on, so it's easy to take off for ventilation. And of course later on, you can always replace it. So that's for ventilation if you just need just the shade only. Alright, it works.
There. Yep, that's me.
It looks like a keeper. Okay, we've been using the Halibut 77 rig, and so far we got a lot of bites, and we finally got two nice 26 inchers. Pretty good size.
What kind of fish is that? I think that's a lizard fish. You see a lot of those little ones inside the bay in Half Moon Bay. Really tiny, but I think this is a lizard fish. Okay, you want to use a hook remover and take him out?
Got himself a go-home fish.
Oh, shit.
I'm short one, but I got a striper, so. Total, we got a total of 5 halibut in here and 1 striper. Right now, we're just trying to get that good luck go-home fish, but if not, we're going to leave in about like 10 minutes, close to the harbor anyway. Just a handful of boat.
handful of boats out here. And he's hooked up another one. And this one's just on the lip.
That's a 22.
Yeah, that looks 22.
This one, look at this, it's right at the tail. I would go here, yeah, but look. if you close the mouth, he's just right on. It's like a hair, judgeable, but knowing the fishing game, you know, they might just say, well, should let it go, but we're gonna let it go.
Okay, he's on. Oh, shit!
If I can get him. He's pointing that way. Try to bring him this way. There you go.
Hold him up more.
Oh, fuck.
Here, hold him up higher.
Oh.
That's a big halibut. This is using the Halibut 7-7 rig. Look at that. Beautiful. Oh, look at this. Okay, guys. Well, we're going to keep fishing. I'll see you guys later.
What the fuck, man?